Hi. This is an unboxing. Well, not really a full unboxing since it's already been unboxed for months. But it's really just a video to show what's inside the Pink Floyd Wish You Were Here Immersion box set and a little review of the music. And I was looking back at my videos. I saw I never did a video of it, so I decided I would do a video showing what's in it. So let's get started. So we have the lid. And here we have a nice little ribbon, so you can easily get the books out, and a piece of foam to keep your balls in there, and there's the marbles. I just don't get this, really. Look at this. What's the point of that? I mean, apparently Pink Floyd thinks we want to see marbles in their $130 box set. I don't know. There's a little ball to keep them, a little ball bag to keep them in there. Is it safe? And we have some coasters that, of course, spell out Pink Floyd. And then they have some artwork on them. There's some suitcases that make up a guy's face. There's the little 40th anniversary Pink Floyd thingy. It's like the four, and then the kind of looks like the division bell head, too. There's the handshake that we all know. Animals by Pink Floyd, that must be an alternate cover. There's some guy. There's like a cartoon version of the division bell heads. I don't even know what that is. There's Alan's Psychedelic Breakfast. That was the artwork from the single, I believe. It's also in the booklet for Adam Heart Mother, which was the album it was on. And then there's some people leaning on air. Okay, that's cool. So yeah, those are the coasters. Here's the Blu-ray disc, which contains material from the box set disc 4 and 5. I mean, 3 and 4. And this has on it, from disc 3, Wish You Were Here 5.1, Surround Sound Mix, Wish You Were Here Original Stereo Mix, the 4.0 Quad Mix, and then from Disc 4, Concert Screen Films in Stereo, Storm Thorgerson Short Film, and Concert Screen Films in Surround Sound. So there's that. Here we have a nice scarf, so you don't get cold. Here's some tons of credits that no one really cares about. You know, just track listings, just who did what, you know, mixing and digital restoration, stuff like that, who wrote it. Everything's mostly by Roger. I mean, all the lyrics are. Memorabilia. We have an old ticket and a backstage pass that you can just throw away. And collector's cards. There's the band. Some beds. Alternate cover for a momentary lapse of reason. That's a tour program that Pink Floyd had back in the 70s for a tour. Instead of having just a regular tour program, they had like a comic. And there's an ad for what does that even say? The Masked Gabget. It's of Oxymize? Okay, Pink Floyd in stereo with the azimuth orbinator. That's nice, some floating ears. Yeah, back to the front. And some info on each of them. Just put those back. See, there's that ribbon comes in handy. You can get that out. Okay, here's a big reproduction of the diver photo. On the record, originally, it was like this small. So, it's a nice big reproduction of it. Here's the first book. There's the cover. You can kind of see it embossed in there. It's Pink Floyd, Wish You Were Here. Ceci n'est pas un livre, which means this is not a book. There's the handshake. There's the track listings on each of the CDs. the lyrics to all the songs so you can sing along. Oh. There's more lyrics and the veil picture. I think that's the UK version. Yep. There's like some waves and the diver picture again. There's the original handshake that was on the actual bag of the vinyl. It originally came in like a black garbage bag. And then that's the actual label that was on the record. There's some reproductions of tickets and stuff like that. There's that's the original cover for Wish You Were Here. That was the original cover. There's the Desert Man. That was an alternate version that was only used in the 2005 calendar. There's the diver picture again. There's the alternate version of the Veil and the USA version of the Burning Man. There's some info. And there's the guy swimming through the desert. There's the band again. Some burning photos. A disassembled bicycle spread across the highway. Some guy standing there with his bicycle, and then some animated kind of pictures of bicycle parts. That's weird. I bought Pink Floyd's largely overly priced, expensive box set and wanted to shoot myself. There's the SHCD version, 2009 version of the Desert Man. And here's that's what the tour program looked like, and here's some reproductions of comics from the tour program. Outtakes from the diver over here, and outtakes from the Burning Man sessions. Yeah, that's cool. Just put that over there. Here's another book. This is the last book. Here's Pink Floyd pictures from 1973 to 1975. Just tons of pictures. I'll go through these kind of fast because I'm running out of time. Band. I think I missed something. Yeah, there's the stage and Roger in that stupid hat. Stage and studio. In the bathroom. It's an interesting picture. And there's in the studio and in the studio again. Yep. And oh, there's a nice color picture. And again in the studio. Okay. I have a minute left. I'll go through this kind of fast. I kind of wanted to show you some of the original artwork from the 1991 remaster of the album. The pictures are mostly used again in that book, most of them. All the lyrics, you know. Anyway, so the first disc here has the original album remastered. Second disc has unreleased tracks. Second disc has unreleased tracks from the album, including live versions, early versions of Shine On You Crazy Diamond, and stuff from Animals. 5 different versions of the album in different surround sound mix that can be played on any DVD player, and concert screen films, and a Storm Thorax and short film. So yeah, there you have it. There's the Pink Floyd Immersion box set. I hope you've enjoyed.